Go back to bed. It's okay, Molly. Annie's here.
It was my mama, Annie, and we were riding on the ferry boat, and she was holding me up to see all the big ships, and then I couldn't find her no more.
Blow. It was only a dream, honey. Now you have to go back to bed. It's past 3 o'clock. Again?
Please?
Sure, Molly. Here it comes again.
Please take care of our little darling. Her name is Annie.
She was born on October 28th. We've got to get her soon.
We have left half of the lock around the neck and kept the other half so that when we come back for her, you will know that she's our baby.
She may be straightening his tie.
saying they loved me and they were coming back for me.
That was 1922. This is 1933. All right, get up. Now for this one, shenanigans. You'll all get down on your naughty little knees and clean this dump till it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building.
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Ah, ha, 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 ha. Get to work. Now! Why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
Sewing machines. There's an order of dresses to finish. If you have
straight through to midnight.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Now line up.
Laundry, laundry man, collecting laundry for Miss Hannigan's orphanage.
Morning, bundles.
Morning, kids. Clean sheets once a month, whether you need them or not. Hey, Aggie. How's the prettiest gal south of 14th Street?
Oh, bundles, get out of here with that laundry.
Aw, shucks. Well, so long, gorgeous, and Merry Christmas.
Bye,
Charlie.
Hey, there's one they didn't get.
They're after you, ain't they?
Well,
they're after me too.
But don't worry, I ain't gonna let them get you or me.
Tomorrow, so you gotta hang on to tomorrow. Yeah.
Well, Molly just threw up on it.
You get away from me!
afternoon, Miss Sparrow.
Good afternoon, Trick. Everyone.
Mr. Warbucks arrived yet?
No, miss. His train from Chicago landed at 3:30, but we're expecting him any minute.
Do you really live here, or is this a train station?
We really live here. Has the carpet been put down in the dining room, Mrs. Greer?
Yes, miss.
Oh, and has the Steinway been tuned?
Yes, miss.
Everything is in order, miss. Mrs. Pugh has prepared his favorite dinner. Fine.
It'll be nice to see Mr. Warbucks again.
Yes, 6 weeks is a long time. Quickly, everyone, everyone, quickly. Everyone, this is Annie. She'll be with us for Christmas. Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear. Now, what do you want to do first?
The floors. I'll scrub them first. Then I'll get to the windows.
Annie, you don't have to do any cleaning. You're our guest.
I suppose you'll have to do. Annie, huh?
Annie what?
Oh, I'm just Annie, Mr. Warbucks, sir. I haven't got any last name. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
Not at all. Couldn't be happier. Grace, we'll start with the figure iron ore shipments from Toledo to Grace. What are we supposed to do with this child?
Well, it is her first night here, sir.
Well, Annie, I guess we ought to do something special for your first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
And then you'll go to the Roxy. Then an ice cream soda at Waffle Miles. Then a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Golly!
Grace, forget about the dictations for tonight. Instead, you will take Annie to the movies.
Yes. Oh, gee.
Something the matter, Annie?
It's hard to say. It's just that, well, I thought you were gonna take me.
What? Oh no, I'm afraid I'll be far too busy tonight.
Oh, gee.
Nine, what a man is running a multi-billion-dollar corporation.
Oh, sure. I know. That's okay, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake?
Yes, sir?
Get our coats.
Oh, gee!
Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Yes, sir.
Which car will you be wanting, sir?
The Duesenberg. No! Wait, this child's been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Why not? It is only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Ah, smell those mushrooms. There's no air like the New York. Come on, you scopebooks. We gotta get to the Roxy before the prices even change. Slow down.
What's that?
The Empire State Building.
Sorry.
Chris, stop slouching.
I wonder if I'll see any movie stars.
Of course you will, dear. Of course you will.
Have you ever been to Fifth Avenue, dear?
Not really.
Well, they have a lot of famous stores there.
Streets, the streets.
Okay.
my left, you will see the Hudson River.
Hope we don't fall off.
Of course we won't fall off, dear.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove that just because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over.
God, I hope not.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? Warbucks fed up with Annie already?
On the contrary, this has to be signed and sent back to the orphanage no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that he wants to adopt her.
Annie? The daughter of a millionaire?
No, the daughter of a billionaire.
Would you excuse me for a moment, please? Got any more wonderful news?
Merry Christmas, Hannigan.
Oops, pardon me, Blondie. Hey, sis. Long time no see.
So, Rooster, they finally let you out of prison? What were you in for this time?
And some old geezers and shrimps of $1,100.
Why do you say that?
Because the Rooster swindled him out of $1,100.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine from
Jersey City.
Rooster, do me a favor. Get out of here.
So who's the blondie I bumped into when I walked in? Looked like she had a couple of dollars.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks? Annie, one of the orphans from here is getting adopted by him.
Crummy orphan.
Yeah, living the life of luxury while the two Hannigan kids end up on the skids. It ain't fair how she scratches during Warbucks. Well, she gets Warbucks.
The little brat. It ain't fair this here life is driving me nuts. Well, we get peanuts. She's living.
Thank you.
Yes, yes, Mr. President. No, I'm not asking for your help, but I'm telling you that you've got to do something. Okay, we'll talk about it on Friday. Friday. Listen, Mr. President, why don't we just bury the hatchet, and then you come here with Mrs. Roosevelt for supper Christmas Eve. You will? Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace, find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany's?
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm gonna give it to her and tell her that I want her doctor.
She's gonna be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her down here.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made a promise to myself. Someday, one way or another, I was going to be rich, very rich.
That was a good idea.
But lately, I've realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you have no one to share your life with, if you're alone, then you might as well be broke. I was in Tiffany's yesterday, and I picked this up for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks. Oh, gee.
It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old broken one you always wear. And I said to myself, I'm gonna get that kid a nice new locket. Here, we'll just take this open off, Ed.
No! I don't want a new one!
Annie, what is it?
This locket! My mom and dad left it with me when they left me at the orphanage, and in no two, they're coming back for me! I know I'm really lucky being here with you for Christmas and all, but the one thing I want in all the world is to find my mother and father, and to be like other kids with folks of my own!
It'll be all right. I'll find them. I'll find your mother and father for you.
Mr. Orbis will find your mother and father if he has to put everybody in the organization on the job. If he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to, and including the White House. Annie, give me a locket.
But Mr. Warbucks.
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace it and find out who bought it.
Okay. Maybe they should have my note, too.
You watch, Annie. You may be meeting your mother and father within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, boy. I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
Thank you.
program, The Oxen and Our Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy. And good evening, Oliver Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening, Bert Healy. It's nice to be here.
Oliver Warbucks, I understand you have something to tell the folks at home about little Annie here.
Yes, Bert Healy. I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I am offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove that they are Annie's parents.
Wow! So, Annie's parents, if you're listening, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that another one of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say accident. Yes, this is your old softie, Mrs. Healy's boy, Bert, saying until next week, same time, same station, good night.
Yeah, come in.
Excuse me, ma'am. Are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah, ma'am. Was you working here 11 years ago? Yeah, why?
Well, we had terrible trouble back then. I leave our baby on the front step.
Our little girl. Our Annie.
You're Annie's parent? I can't believe it! Where do you say you're from again?
A little farm up in Canada. There's lots of chickens and ducks and geese and roosters! Captain Dunnaboo! Gotcha, sis!
Rooster, I would have never known it was you in 100 years!
Fooled you, Aggie, we're gonna fool Warbucks too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
But we need your help. For the details about Annie, to help us pull this thing off.
What's in it for me?
Three-way split.
Half.
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 Fine. 25 grand each. We get the kid, we get the check, and we get out of town.
The kid's the problem. What do we do with her afterwards?
No problem. When I want something to disappear, it disappears for good. We get the kid, we get the check, then we blow this crummy town, and me and Mo meet you.
Where? Oh, yeah.
In Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
I'm so sorry.
That's okay. You did your best. Anyway, I guess a kid can get along without folks. You didn't turn out so bad.
Grace?
Yes, sir?
Do you have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
Well, if I can't have my real mother and father, then there's no one in the world I'd rather have for you than a father, Mr. Warbucks.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the world you want come to it. Who would you like?
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell here, and Mr. Drake, and Mrs. Pugh, and well, everybody here.
Drake?
Yes, sir?
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids.
It'll be way past their bedtime now. But I'll tell you what, we'll have everyone from the orphanage here tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid. Annie!
I've lost her! I've lost Annie!
Sir, I have the strangest feeling that I've seen Mr. Mudge before, and he's not who he says he is.
Then we won't give up until we're certain.
But how?
I'll find a way. I'll go straight to the top, to the President of the United States, even if he is a Democrat.